गुड मॉर्निंग थर्ड क्लास। सो थर्ड क्लास वी वर रिवाइजिंग चैप्टर 4, सो अंडरस्टैंडिंग विंडोज। सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू रिवाइज पेज नंबर 32 ऑफ चैप्टर 4, दैट इज अरेंजिंग एंड सॉर्टिंग द आइकन्स। नाउ इन दिस पेज वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी हाउ वी अरेंज एंड सॉर्ट द आइकन्स। I have already made you understand last week what are icons and how we arrange the icons. Now first is click on the blank area of desktop. You will find the list of options in the shortcut menu which appears. Select the view option. Click on the auto arrange icons option from the submenu. Observe the changes. Now sorting the out. Icons, that means choosing, selecting. When you arrange icons properly on the desktop, it is called sorting the icons. When you right click on the blank area of the desktop, a shortcut menu appears. Point to the sort by option and click on the name sub option. The icons will be arranged in an alphabetic order. So, next is mouse pointer shapes. So, these are the shapes on the mouse pointer changes according to the activities we perform. Now, this circle shows busy. It means that computer is busy and wants to you to wait. Now, double headed arrow for resizing the window or picture. I-beam for inserting text in a document. Normal for pointing, selecting and dragging the items on the screen. Four-headed arrow for moving pictures and toolbars. Working in background, it means that computer is processing while you are working. Now, changing the desktop background. The picture that appears as the background of a desktop is called the wallpaper. You can change the appearance of the desktop background according to your choice. Now, the following steps are there. First is right click anywhere on the desktop. You will find the first list of options. This is called the shortcut menus. Choose the personalized option. The personalization dialog box will appear. Click on desktop background. A new window with multiple images will appear. Under choose your desktop background option, we can select one picture for desktop background or select more than one picture to create a slideshow. Select any background from the displayed list. A preview of the selected background will appear on the monitor. After selecting, click on Save Change button and close the dialog box. So this is way we can change the wallpaper on the desktop. So next is changing the screen saver. Now this is on page number 33. The screen saver is an image which pops up on the computer screen whenever a computer remains idle for some time. By pressing any key, you can get back to the normal screen again. Now follow these steps. First, right click on the blank area of the desktop. Click on Personalize option from the shortcut menu. The personalization dialog box will appear. Click on the screen saver option. Click on the drop down arrow in screen saver section and select a screen saver of your choice. A mini preview of the screen saver will be displayed in the preview box. To watch the preview box on full screen, click on the preview button. Move the mouse to come back to the screen saver window. So, your last thing is shut down your computer. to shut down, follow these steps. Click on start button. Now select shut down button. The system will take a few seconds and will shut down. So with this, your chapter 4 is completed, and I have prepared study material. Some extra questions also I have added. So write all the question answers in your fair notebook and learn it. Good day.